Good morning, students. In today's class, I am going to teach a very important grammar topic to you in your English, that is direct and indirect speech. What is direct speech and what is indirect speech? If you observe, in direct speech, suppose one person said something to you, the information you are conveying to others by using the exact words quoted by the person. This kind of speech is called as the direct speech. Suppose if we report that information, otherwise if you describe that information to others in your own words, that exact words quoted by the person you are not using, this kind of the speech is called as the indirect speech. I will explain this direct and indirect speech with the help of the two example sentences. If you observe, Sohan said to Mohan, I am going to school. Sohan saying that I am going to school to Mohan. Here the exact words used by the Sohan, I use here, I am going to school. As the person is using the exact words used by the Sohan to pass that information to some others, it is called as the direct speech. The indirect speech, if you observe, Sohan told Mohan that he was going to school. In this one, that he was going to school, it is not the exact, these are not the exact words used by the Sohan. The person is describing, the person is reporting that information in the person's own words, he or she, the person's own words, the person is describing or reporting that information to someone else. This kind of the speech is called as the reported speech. If you observe in this direct speech, here the reporting clause and the reported speech, two parts are there. The first part, Sohan said to Mohan. Here, this part is called as the reporting clause. Here, the said is called as the reporting verb. After the comma, whichever the part is was kept in the inverted commas, this part is called as the reported speech. This will be helpful to you when we are following some rules to change the direct speech into indirect speech. Here, the rules we observe to change the direct speech to indirect speech. The first one is inverted commas you have to remove. In indirect speech, there is no inverted commas. If you observe here, Sohan said to Mohan, I am going to school. Here the I am going to school, the reported speech part was kept in the inverted commas. But when we change this direct speech to indirect speech, that inverted commas were removed. Next here the conjunctions also we have to use. The conjunctions are the that, if, when. In the first sentence, if you observe, Sohan said to Mohan, I am going to school. Sohan said, told Mohan that he was going to school. Here the that conjunction was used and the inverted commas were removed. Next here the if also I said, with if also an example sentence I mentioned. He said to me, do you like the books? Here the he asked me if I like the book. Here the if I used as the conjunction and the inverted commas were removed. These are the rules we have to follow when we are changing one sentence from direct speech to indirect speech. That one sir, commas, inverted commas we have to remove, conjunctions like that, if, whether we have to use. Next, reporting verb will be changed based on our sense. That is told, asked, inquired, advised, requested, like this. There are so many ways the reporting verb will be changed. In this one, if you observe, he said to me. Here, with the person says, I am using here the ask, said to instead, I am using the ask. Suppose the person is inquiring about something, the person is advising something, the person is requesting something, here the said will be changed as asked, inquired, advised, requested, like this, it will be changed. Reporting verb will be changed. Here the change of the pronoun. The first sentence if you observe, Sohan said to Mohan, I am going to school. Here the I pronoun is changed as the he, as the Sohan is male, a boy. Here the suppose if we took a girl, here the I will be changed as the she. Suppose any non-living thing or otherwise any object will be took, the I will be changed as the it. Like this, the I will be changed as he, she, it. Here the suppose if you took any third person pronouns like we, you, they, this one's won't change. The exact third person pronouns will come here. Okay, I hope you understand this rules to change the direct speech into indirect speech. Here, how the tense will change? That will be observed now. How the tense will change? Reporting verb, suppose if it is named the present tense. I already told you this says. This one is called as the reporting verb. Said is called as the past tense reporting verb. Here the says as I am using, this is the present tense reporting verb. Suppose the reporting verb is there in the present tense. Here the reported speech, tense you should not change. Suppose you observe, Satish says, I am flying a kite. So the indirect speech is, Satish says that he is flying a kite. These two sentences if you observe, I have changed as the he. But the reported speech, tense is not changing. This sentence also there in the I am flying a kite, it is there in the present progressive tense, present continuous tense. He is flying a kite also there in the present progressive, that means present continuous tense. As I am using, I instead the he pronoun. Instead of the the is coming, but the tense is not changed. This one you have to keep in your mind. The reporting verb is there in the present tense, like says, like this. The reported speech, tense is not changing. When we are changing the sentence from direct speech to indirect speech, that conjunction we have to use, and reported speech, inverted commas, we have to print. And I instead, based on the subject, the pronoun we have to use. As Satish is a boy, here we are using the he. Next, suppose the reported speech, reported verb, reporting verb, is there in the past tense. Here I am not using the says, here it is the said. Because said, I write a letter. Here some rules and regulations we have to follow. Here the rules I will give to you in today's assignment as the one table that you observe very clearly. Just I have explained that one to you. Because said, I wrote a letter. If you observe this one, I write a letter, it is there in the simple present tense. The simple present tense will be changed into simple past tense. If you observe, because said that, inverted commas were removed, I instead he gave, right instead I wrote the proof. Means simple present tense will be changed into simple past tense. Because said I write a letter changed into, because said that he wrote a letter. Next, because said I am writing a letter. In this one, because said that, inverted commas were removed, I place I wrote the he, because he is a male, a boy. Because said that he was writing a letter. I am writing a letter, it is there in the present continuous tense. He was writing a letter, it is there in the past continuous tense. Because said I have written a letter. If you observe carefully, I have written a letter, it is there in the present perfect tense. According to the rule, present perfect tense will be changed into past perfect tense. Because said that he had written a letter. Have instead had written. Present perfect tense have become past perfect tense had written. Because said that he had written a letter. Next, because said I wrote a letter. This one, if you observe keenly, this I wrote a letter, it is there in the simple past tense. According to the rule, the simple past tense will be changed into past perfect tense. If you observe the indirect speech, because said that he had written a letter. Simple past tense is changed into past perfect tense. Next, because said I was writing a letter. This is past continuous tense. The past continuous tense is changed into past perfect continuous tense. Because said that he had been writing a letter. I was writing a letter is changed into he had been writing a letter. Okay, these are all the rules will be applied to the direct speech when we are changing the verb from direct speech to indirect speech. If the reporting verb is there in past tense, that is the said. Suppose if it is there in the present tense, these all the rules won't apply, which we should not apply. The exact tense we have to write, even in the indirect speech also. And these rules also won't apply. Suppose if any universal truth in the reported speech, otherwise any habitual action in the reported speech, otherwise any historical event in the reported speech, we should not apply this method of the rules. Example sentence I will say, he said the sun rises in the east. This is a universal truth. When we are changing this statement from direct speech to indirect speech, this rules that simple present tense will be changed into simple past tense, present continuous tense will be changed into past continuous tense. This kind of the rules we should not apply here. The exact statement we have to, he said that the sun rises in the east. Here the tense won't be changed, that exact sentence only we have right here, because this statement, it is the universal truth. Next, Rakesh said, I am an early riser. It is a habitual action of the Rakesh. If you are describing any habitual action also, here we should not apply the rules. That simple present tense will be changed into simple past tense. Kind of the table what I told you, this table rules we should not follow. Here the exact sentence we have to use. Exact tense we have to use. Rakesh said that he is an early riser. He is an early riser. Here the tense won't be changed. This we have to keep in your mind when you are changing one sentence from direct speech to the indirect speech. Okay, my dear students, this is the first teaching video in the grammar topic direct and indirect speech. Indirect speech. The second video, some more rules and regulations I will tell to you to change the direct speech sentences from direct speech to indirect speech. Along with this teaching video, I am giving an assignment also to you. Please complete this assignment. This is your today's homework.